Sodium carbonate is the ninth most important inorganic compound in terms of quantity used. It exists as the anhydrous state, commonly known as soda ash, and it's also known in hydrated form as both the monohydrate and mainly as the decahydrate, which is also known as washing soda. In North America, soda ash is chiefly obtained by processing natural occurring deposit of a mineral called trona, which consists chemically in impure sodium sesquicarbonate, which formula is presented here. Sodium sesquicarbonate is a compound in which the crystal lattice contains alternating carbonate and hydrogen carbonate ions in equimolar proportion, and for each couple of carbonate and hydrogen carbonate ions are intercalated 3 sodium ions and 2 water molecules. Trona occurs in deposit around 400 meters underground and is recovered employing dry and wet methods. Dry mining is similar to underground coal mining by shearing the trona for the face, dropping the recovered trona onto continuous conveyor system, and move to the surface from the latter used as feed in the processing plant. For recover the residual trona, wet mining is used by injecting a solution from the surface which dissolves the mineral, forming an alkali-rich solution that is then pumped back to the surface for processing. This wet mining procedure can be also used in previously unmined ground. Processing of trona involves removing some impurities by employing calcination and recrystallization technique in order to convert all sesquicarbonate to carbonate. There are two alternative processes that can be employed. The process known as monohydrate process, which consists of first roast the crust ore to form crude carbonate, as it illustrates the following equation. Sodium carbonate is then dissolved in water and the insoluble impurities are filtered off. The resulting solution is finally concentrated to crystallize the monohydrate, that finally is calcined to give anhydrous sodium carbonate. The other process is known as the sesquicarbonate process, which consists of dissolved trona in water to remove the impurities by clarification, evaporation and cooling. The refined trona is then calcined to form soda ash. Although in the United States most sodium carbonate is produced from the mineral trona, because it's come with large deposits in Wyoming, in other zones of the world sodium carbonate is obtained by the solvay process. This process was designed by a Belgian chemist, Ernest Solvay, and it consists on converting table salt and limestone to soda ash and calcium chloride, as illustrated in the following equation. The problem is that the position of disequilibrium lies far to the left, so this reaction cannot be accomplished directly. Instead, the product is obtained by a set of reactions that in overall conduct to the previous whole equation. Let's describe the solvay process in detail. First, the brine used in the process needs to be concentrated to at least 30% by some evaporation, and the impurities have to be removed by precipitation. The purified brine is then passed through an ammonia thawer to be saturated in ammonia, and the solution is cooled because the dissolving process is exothermic. Next, carbon dioxide, produced by heating limestone, is bubbled into the solution of sodium chloride saturated with ammonia, and we obtain sodium hydrogen carbonate, as is shown in the following reaction. The reaction is stopped at about 75% completion in order to avoid the precipitation of ammonium bicarbonate. The sodium bicarbonate salt crystallizes from the mixture and it can be transferred to sodium carbonate by roasting, liberating carbon dioxide that can be reused again in the process. Additionally, the ammonium chloride solution is treated with the quicklime remaining from the calcination of the limestone, and the liberated ammonia are also reused in the process. This final reaction produces calcium dichloride as byproduct, which can be seen as a problem due to the demand of this compound is much less than the amount produced in this process. The solvay process has other disadvantages. related with its higher cost and therefore is being largely supplanted by the simple method of extraction for trona. Finally, we can obtain easily sodium carbonate in the laboratory by reaction of sodium peroxide with carbon monoxide, or alternatively by reaction of sodium peroxide with carbon dioxide, what liberates oxygen in the process, which make this reaction the basis of its application in breathing apparatus. Regarding the application of sodium carbonate, one of the most important applications is in glass industry. The process of making glass consists of melting together at a 1500 degrees Celsius sodium carbonate, limestone and sand to produce molten glass. Recycled glass can be also added to the mixture. Sodium carbonate is also used for softening water by removing alkaline earth ions by converting them in their insoluble salts. Additionally, it is also used as substitute of sodium hydroxide in many of its applications, such as paper pulping or cleansing agent or component of soap, powders or detergents. Another interesting use is in flue gas desulfurization, which consists on the reduction of sulfur pollution resulting from exhaust flue gases of fossil fuel power plants and other large furnaces. Powdered sodium carbonate is injected with the fuel and react with sulfur dioxide to give solids a sodium sulfide that can be removed by filtration or precipitation.